Welcome, my dear students, in the class 12th of English. I am Rashmi, lecturer, AD Government Girls Inter College, Gorakhpur. And today, I am going to teach you a very inspirational poem. The name of the poem is My Heaven. Look at the word heaven. The general conception about heaven we have that it is the place where God lives. And people, good people, go to the heaven after their death. Now, what the idea we can derive out of this word is that heaven is a place on, if we think about it in the context of on the earth, it is the place where one can live peacefully and happily. So, the poet here talks about this kind of heaven. Now, I must tell you about the poet. Dear children, you must know that who is the composer of national anthem, Jan Gan Man. I am quite sure that you are aware of this name, Rabindranath Tagore. A very great poet and a prolific genius. And I must tell you one more thing about this poem, that this poem is an extract from his famous work. The name of the work is Gitanjali. And Gitanjali is a book, and Tagore got Nobel Prize for this book in the year 1913. Now, I hope you must have got the idea about this poem, My Heaven. Now, before we go for the poem, let's have crystal clear objectives of the poem. The first objective is to know the theme of the poem. We will try to analyze the theme of the poem. What does the poet want to deliver to us? We will try to search for that. The second, to inculcate the meaning of the feeling of patriotism. To inculcate the feeling of patriotism, here we will try to learn the feeling of patriotism, the sense of love for our country. So, this poem beautifully inculcates in us the feeling of patriotism. Third, to know the central idea of the poem. As we read any poem, if we don't know the central theme, the central idea of the poem, it's useless. So, we will try to find out that. Fourth, to be familiar with the meaning of the difficult words. As we read the poem, we find certain words which are quite difficult to understand. So, here we will make it clear. Now, to elaborate the poem, I will explain the poem. In this way, you will be able to understand the entire idea of the poem. What is the poem all about? You will be able to understand that. So, these are the objectives of the poem, and we will analyze this beautiful poem in the context of all these objectives, and we will obtain it. So, before I go for the poem, once more, there is about the poet. You must have curiosity to know about this great persona, Rabindranath Tagore. Dear children, it's a matter of pride for us that today we are going to learn about an Indian poet. So, as we have seen that in our syllabus, there are so many foreign authors and poets. But if we look at here, Rabindranath Tagore, he is an Indian. So, it's a matter of dignity too. So, let's start. Rabindranath Tagore was a prolific genius. He was a social reformer. He was a great patriot, a great philosopher, a great poet, and above all, a great humanitarian. The second, he was born in the year 1961, Kolkata. Earlier, it was used to be called as Calcutta. Death, 1941, Kolkata. Third, award, Nobel Prize in Literature, 1913. As I told you that he got the Nobel Prize in the year 1913. Also, he was knighted in the year 1915, but he gave up the knighthood in protest against Jallianwala Bagh. What happened there? That there was a General Dyer who ordered his troops of British Army to fire rifle into the crowd of unarmed Indian civilian. So he was quite angry and discarded this knighthood. Fourth, major works. First of all, we will look at the poems. Gitanjali comes first. The Crescent Moon, Fruit Gathering, Lover's Gift. Next, come to the plays. Chitra, Sacrifice, third, Post Office, novels, Gora, The Wreck, The Home. Now come to the short stories, The Homecoming and The Kabuliwala. These are the famous works by Rabindranath Tagore. Fifth, Gandhiji always addressed him as Guru Dev. Now, come to the poem. Now, before we read the text, before we try to analyze the poem, I must tell you about the background of the poem so that we can have an idea of the poem, what is all about the poem. The poem is an extract from Tagore's famous work Gitanjali. I have already told it to you that it has been extracted from Gitanjali. Second, it represents Tagore as one of the builders of the spirit of modern India. He has carved a very beautiful picture of modern India in this poem. And I must tell you, dear children, that this poem is quite inspirational and energizing for you. Third, the poet gives the picture of an ideal country such as he would like his country to be. Fourth, this is a prose poem. Have you heard this term, that prose poem? Prose poem, as it is clear from this name, that it is a kind of poem that is not in verse form. In fact, it is in prose form, but it contains certain poetic qualities like heightened imagery and effective emotions, figures of speech. So, it's a kind of prose poem. Fifth, although it was written before independence, it has a wider and everlasting appeal. So, this was the background of the poem. And what we have got through this, that we have to talk about our country in this poem, and we will get some more ideas as we proceed. Now come to the text. This is a beautiful poem, dear children, and it's a kind of prayer to the Almighty Rabindranath Tagore does here. He prays to God and he asks for something. He imagines something, and the imagination is quite colorful and inspirational, I can say. And if you read the poem, you must have got the idea of the of his sense and his feeling. Where the mind is without fear and the head is held high, where knowledge is free, where the world has not been broken, up into fragments by narrow domestic walls. Where words come out from the depth of truth, where tireless striving stretches its arms towards perfection. Next, where the clear stream of reason has into the dreary desert sand of dead habit. Where the mind is led forward by thee into ever widening thought and action, not lost its way. Into that heaven of freedom, my father, let my country awake. So this was the poem, and there are certain difficult words: striving, struggling, dreary, dark, domestic walls, internal division, dead habit, old and useless customs. So this is the meaning of these difficult words, and the meaning has been taken in the context of the poem. I must tell you this thing. Now we come to the explanation of the poem. Where the mind is without fear and the head is held high, Tagore draws a picture of free India. Now here we will analyze free from what. He says that there should be a human society, there should be people who will be fearless, who will not live under any domination or forced compulsion. They will be free, and the head is held high. He imagines that the people of his country would live with dignity, with honor in the country, where knowledge is free. This is also quite inspirational that he says that I want India to be a place where knowledge is free for everyone. It should not be restricted to a specific class, or you can say upper class. So it should be free from that, where the world has not been broken up into fragments by narrow domestic walls. Children, look at the words narrow domestic walls. He says that I want India that should not be divided on the basis of caste, creed, culture, language or religion. So our India should be free from all these things. There should not be conservatism, superstitions. So he wants a fearless and totally independent India, where words come out from the depth of truth. He thinks that there should be a place where people will be quite truthful, not superficial, where words should come from the bottom of the heart, where tireless striving stretches its arms towards perfection, where people make constant effort, tireless striving. They do not tired of their struggle. And for what? To reach perfection in their life. So here you can find out very easily that tireless striving stretches its arms towards perfection. There is personification figure of speech. And so this is the first part. Now come to the second, where the clear stream of reason has not lost its way. What he means to say here, that where the people can live freely, the first thing, and and the clear stream of reason has not lost its way, where the people are not slave to dead ideas, to conservatism, to superstitions. So into the dreary desert sand of dead habit. Here you can find out that clear stream of reason. Reason has been compared to the stream, flowing stream. So here again we have metaphor. Into the dreary desert sand of dead habit. Dead habit has been compared as dreary desert, where there is no progress. People are quite unprogressive. So what he says here, that he does not want India to be a place where the dead habits, where the superstitions, where the conservatism, where casteism. So there are certain things which hinder the path of progress. So he wants India to be free from all these things, and reason should be in dominance. All the decisions, all the ideas should be new. They should always be, people of India should always be ready to accept new ideas and to explore knowledge for the progress. Where the mind is led forward by thee, thee refers to God, into ever widening thought and action. Where the people of India are ready to be dynamic and progressive under the inspiration of God. Into that heaven of freedom, my father, let my country awake. Here apostrophe, figure of speech is present. He says that this kind of heaven where the people are free, heaven of freedom. So this kind of place he wants India to be, and he says that I want the people of India should awake in this blissful condition. So this was the text, and what we have learned through this poem, that this poem is a beautiful imagination. If we find India, what Tagore presents here, it will be quite good. It will be a blessing for us. So now we will move towards the central idea of the poem, as we have already known the explanation of the poem. So what we have got, the central theme. My Heaven is an inspiring poem composed by Rabindranath Tagore. You know about it. It is an extract from Gitanjali, for which he got the Nobel Prize in the year 1913. In this poem, he visualizes a country where the people's minds are free and fair. Free from what? Free from fear and narrow-mindedness such as casteism, racialism, conservatism, superstitions. He prays to God that India may become a place where knowledge is shared freely by all, when people are not rigid, and when they choose the path of truth under God's guidance. So this is the idea where he says that our country should be an ideal country. There should be a peace, there should be prosperity in our country. How can we attain that? If our minds are free from fear and narrow-mindedness and casteism, racialism, because these are the things which ultimately create an obstacle in the progress of any country. So this is the central idea. Now come to the format of explanation. Where the clear to country away. Reference. These inspiring lines have been taken from the poem My Heaven by Rabindranath Tagore. This poem is an extract from his famous poem Gitanjali. So you can write the reference in this way. Now come to the context. In these lines, Tagore expresses his vision of a new enlightened India. Explanation, I have already explained it to you about the poem. Now come to the comments. You can add comments like its rhythm gives a lasting melody. What is the meaning of that lasting melody? That it has a kind of pleasant tune. Second, the poem is filled with patriotism. The poem is filled with the sense of love for the country. Third, figures of speech. First, metaphor, clear stream of reason. There is metaphor, dreary desert sand of dead habit. There is also metaphor, heaven of freedom, metaphor. So metaphor, we have three words. Personification, country is personified here to be away. So there is personification. Now come to the questions for evaluation. First, how does Tagore want to make India to be? Tagore wants India to be a place where people can live freely. They can have a peaceful and prosperous life. Whose mind is the poet is talking about and why? Here the poet is talking about the mind of people who are biased, who are prejudiced, and they are not taking decisions on the basis of reason. They have mind but they don't use it. So he says that they should use their mind and there should be clear stream of reason to take any decision and to make further progress. What is meant by mind is without fear? We already know this line that mind is without fear means where the people can live freely without any domination. Because in society still we have the problem of domination, so it creates a kind of fear. So he wants India to be a place where people can live with dignity and they can have a fearless life without any forced compulsion or domination. So this was the questions for evaluation. Now come to the homework. Explain the lines where knowledge is free, where the world has not been broken up into fragments by narrow domestic walls. And second, write the theme of the poem in your words. So you have to write down in your copy. You can solve it. You can solve some more questions too in order to understand the poem in a better way. Now, this is the last section of our study and message of the text. The importance of true freedom is beautifully portrayed in this poem. Actually, dear children, Rabindranath Tagore has focused on this topic especially, that is freedom. But here we have to analyze that this freedom is not the freedom from the British army. This is not the freedom. This is, he talks about here a freedom that is a kind of true freedom. A freedom which we want to have in our society. There may be a reason that he derived this idea from the slavery that we had. But here he talks about freedom, that is the freedom of mind, speech, behavior, action, practice, whatever you can say. So there should be freedom. Everyone wants to have a free life. Nobody wants to live under any compulsion. So the beautiful idea of freedom has been beautifully portrayed, beautifully explained in this poem. Second, this poem emphasizes that countrymen should be broad-minded and progressive. For the development of any country, what is needed? That the countrymen should be broad-minded, not the narrow-minded. They should always be ready to accept new ideas, good ideas, based on the reason, based on the mind, based on the analysis. Not conservatism should not be followed. And progressive, they should always be ready, they should always be anxious to make progress in their country. The poet advises people to have faith in God as he is the supreme power. Society should not be divided on the basis of caste, creed and religion. Dear children, that's all for today. Again, I'll meet some new topic, some energizing topic. Till then, have a great time. Thank you very much.